it with your name on it. All you gotta do is receive it. God is handing out blessings.
Yes.
There's nothing wrong with that.
There's nothing wrong with being blessed. There's nothing wrong with being blessed, but you gotta do God's will. You gotta keep His will. You gotta pay your tithes. You gotta give an offering. Yeah, there is a condition.
You gotta be a giver.
Luke 6:38 says, pressed down, shaken together, running over, will He give it back to you.
Yes.
You see, God gave first. God didn't tell you to do anything. He was the first example. He gave His best. He gave His son. He gave the son. God gave first. He gave the son who died, who gave His life. Jesus died on Calvary for you one day. That you might have the right to the tree of life. He came down here born of a woman. A young girl named Mary. A virgin girl. Born of the Holy Ghost. But He was still in the flesh. They said He was God's son, but He was in the flesh. He was part man and part God. He was in the flesh. He went through all the stages for you. He was a newborn. He was an infant. He was a toddler. He was a preschooler. He was a school age. He was a preteen. He was a teenager. He was an adult. Jesus went through all the stages. Jesus had to eat like you and I. Yes, he had to sleep. He was a carpenter. He worked a job. He said, I leave my deity up there with my father.
Yes, he did.
When the Roman soldiers came up against him, they take him to the cross. He didn't use his power. He could have. Just spoke the word. God would send a legion of angels. But Jesus didn't, because He loved you so much. He saw the sins of man. He saw your pain. He saw your anger. He saw your hurt. He saw your despair. He saw the devil oppressing you. He said, now I can't. I can't go do my Father's will. He said, now my will, Lord, but your will be done. I can't do it. I gotta go to that cross. So He went down to the Garden of Gethsemane. Because He felt it. He felt the weight of the world on His shoulders. Don't you think Jesus didn't do it? He didn't feel the, as they said, the sweat came out like blood. Because He knew what He had to go through. He knew what He had to go through. Has anybody ever saw the passions of Christ? My God, my God. They said they whipped them all night long. They said He never said a mumbling word. They placed a thorny crown on His head. The blood came streaming down. Jesus knew He had to go through this so you and I could receive salvation to this day. So we can be set free. Set free from lust. Set free from rape. Set free from molestation. Set free from depression. Set free from suicide. Set free from anger.
Yes.
My God, my God. Hallelujah. They said they pierced Him in the side. I came blood and water. But Jesus said, no man take it my way. He said, I give it freely. He said, no man. I give this life. I give this life. Hallelujah! Because He had to do it. You see, Jesus was the ultimate sacrifice.
Right.
You see, if you go back in Old Testament times, they used to offer up bulls, heifers, and rams of virginality, of purity, for their different sins. Pharisees that really did it, because the word of God hurt them so much, because they were not in the word. They were the spiritual leaders. They had a form of godliness, but not according to knowledge. They were stuck on tradition. And they expected God to send down his son to reestablish the natural kingdom. But Jesus came down to reestablish the spiritual kingdom. So some action could come to you and I, but they couldn't receive that. So they called him a blasphemer. Hallelujah. Blaspheming. Because he said he was the son of God. When they asked him, are you the son of God? He said, thou hast said. Hallelujah.
Spirituality that fall from the table, I'll take the Lord.